What's up, everybody? PG Braun here, president of Blackstone Labs. I'm here with the beast, Stephen Wain. This is his last day here in Boca, and we are doing back. We're going to emphasis on width today. He does two different back days. And today we're going to prioritize width a little bit. He is about 9 weeks out from North Americans. He's in tremendous shape already. Really doesn't have any true weaknesses, in my opinion. Obviously, he's got a very, very impressive chest and shoulders. Back is pretty good, too. We already crushed legs and chest early in the week. And although we do lots of videos with shoulders and arms and whatnot, back is a very, very, very important body part. I always tell people shows are won from the back. So back needs to be approached very, very calculated. You can't just do your whole workout based around row exercises, although I feel rows are the most important, and you can't just sit in the gym doing all sorts of pull downs. So today we're going to do a back width emphasized workout, and we're going to do a lot of variations of row exercises, some that you've probably already done and some that you might not have. But I guarantee if you try this workout on your own, you might not be as wide as him, but you'll definitely increase your width yourself. So we're going to get into it. And thank you so much always to Bethany for letting us shoot at Pure Life in Boca, and congratulations, Bethany, for just winning the Masters Bikini Tim Gardner show. Nice big win. We're going to win a bunch of those this year. And this is Operation Pro Card at North Americans. Win. We're going to get into it now. We're going to start out with underhand pull down, underhand barbell rows. And so there's a lot of ways to do barbell rows, right? Most common way you see people do is an overhand barbell row, and they're bent all the way over and they're doing their rows, right? So Dorian Yates made the underhand barbell row a lot more known. And I actually use this particular version of the row as kind of like a bread and butter of my back building routine. Now, when you do these, you're actually staying a lot more upright than a normal row. So you're not gonna be bent all the way over like this. You're actually gonna be almost more at like 70 degrees. And your elbows are coming in close to your body, and you're pulling into the lower part of your abdomen, basically where your belt would be on your pants. Elbows gotta stay in though, they can't be jutting out like this. This is what's gonna emphasize really, really stretching and pulling the lower lats. And I can already, with just this bar, feel blood coming into my lower lats. It's very important that you stay upright with your chest and you concentrate on just squeezing your lats back when you do these. It's a shorter range of motion. Overhand barbell row, you're gonna really, really get this pull. The underhand, it's all about just squeezing your lats in. So, obviously he's a very strong guy, but we wanna make sure that we're doing our lighter weights first, getting blood in. So, I mean, and this is one of those things that, you know, if you got a pair of straps, you can go really heavy on, but you'll get more out of it going a little lighter and concentrating on squeezing your lats a lot more. So when he's doing these, he's gonna concentrate on pulling straight through here and really activating and firing his lats in here through the insertion. I'm gonna have Eric show you guys in the back how his lats are firing, and you can actually already see his rotations coming out. I throw a 45 on there. Yeah. I'm gonna show you guys a great way to stretch your lats. So if you find a pole or something to grab onto, you can do this on both sides. So what you're gonna do is, the side that you're stretching, so I'm gonna stretch, I'll stretch my left side first. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my right side, I'm gonna grab a pull like this, I'm gonna take my left side, I'm gonna hold it a little bit higher, and I'm gonna let my body weight pull away on it, and I can move around here and I'm actually feeling the stretch all the way down into my waist. You're letting your body weight pull away. Then we want to do the other side. You switch. You go up higher on that other side, and you're pulling away. And you should be able to feel the stretch all the way down the side of your body, because depending on where your lats insert, some of us, our lats insert higher than others, but you should actually feel the stretching all the way down the side of your body. From the back, because he's lean enough. So we're really focusing on right here. And as you can see, there's actually striations already coming out through here. And we're really, really focusing on this meat. Cool, we don't often get people that are lean enough during videos that we can actually see the exact muscles that we're working and where.
That one meal workout.
Now this workout, guys, when you're by yourself and you're moving, especially if you're breaking back into 2 days, this workout will take you 40 to 45 minutes. Yeah. It's not gonna be a brutally long workout. You're gonna get a lot done in a quick amount of time. And that's how it should be. Especially if you're breaking out body parts into multiple days like that. Like my shoulder workouts, I could do a hard, intense shoulder workout back then in 30 minutes, really. Because you shouldn't be sitting around doing laterals and waiting for minutes in between your sets.
Such a small muscle.
You know what I mean? You should be moving through them fast. Now, when you're doing your, you know, heavy barbell presses and bent over rows, you're gonna need a little bit of time to get ready for the next sets, but you wanna move at a good pace. So we're gonna go again now.
Whew.
And we're shooting for 10 reps. And again, these are ones that I want him to really concentrate on his form. He could probably put on, he could throw some straps on and do 315 and crank out reps, but he's just gonna be jerking it up. The way he's doing it right now, he's really controlling it, which is what we want. Good. 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 Another one. Good. There we go.
That was heavy.
Awesome. Do you use straps?
Yeah.
You have them with you? So when you guys are training back, I hear different things from people on whether or not you should use straps. Like some people are like, oh, you know, straps are for pussies. And other people are like, oh, you should train straps. My opinion on straps is your forearms are gonna fail way before your back does. And so if you're trying to focus on your back, you should absolutely use straps. So the way that I train now, I don't use weight that's heavy enough to really worry about my forearms that much. And so I don't need straps. But when you're doing barbell rows and dumbbell rows and T-bar rows and you're using a large amount of weight, you don't wanna be focusing on holding on to the weight. You wanna be focusing on squeezing with your back. So for that reason, straps are very important. Today, I'm not gonna have him doing anything that is ridiculously heavy. We're focusing more on squeezing and moving at the right pace. But it will still be, you know, a little more challenging without having the straps. But the one good side of that is, if you do have lagging forearms, you're gonna work your forearms really hard on your back day. And I always tell people say all the time, they're like, you know, what do you do for your forearms? I'm like, just don't use straps.
Yeah.
Your forearms are gonna get worked like crazy. I don't do, some guys will, but I don't do forearm exercises. When I was very young, I used to actually have a day where I would do like calves, abs, forearms, and I'd do all sorts of wrist curls and reverse curls and whatnot, but your grip gets so much work on back day. And if you're not using straps, you're gripping like crazy the whole time. Your brachioradialis is involved in all these pulling exercises, and so that muscle gets stimulated like crazy too. So again, we're gonna go right into this one. Come on. Good. 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 Come on. Another one. There we go. Good. Very good. Whew. We'll pull that 10 off. And I'm actually gonna throw another 25 on. And this is gonna be the last set of these.
Believe it or not, my legs are way worse today.
Really?
Way worse.
Normally they're gonna be worse 48 hours instead of 24. That was a really hard workout. Especially because you did a bunch of different stuff too.
Yeah.
When you throw different stuff into the mix and your body's not used to it, you're just gonna be way more sore.
Total shocker.
That's good though. When you go back to your other stuff, you'll probably be extra sore from going back to it also.
Right.
This last set, make sure his forearms are ready for it. And the underhand version of this exercise, when you don't have straps, you're gonna wanna pull with your biceps a lot too, which you're gonna get some blood in there, but what we really wanna do is make sure that we're concentrating on just using the hands as grips, basically, and getting the lats to squeeze, because you're pulling with your bicep, it's a lot of stress on the bicep. Another reason why you want to use straps too. So this will be the last set. Again, we're going to focus for going for like 10 good reps and just getting the right squeeze. Ooh, that's my baby. Good. 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 Come on. Three more good ones. Come on. Keep it going. Another one. Good.
Shit.
Good trick form, too. Now, so we got some good heavy stuff here in the beginning, fresh. We're gonna move over here. I actually want him to hold it here, not here. So we're gonna hold it here on the inside. And when you pull back on this, you are gonna let your elbows come out a little bit on this one. All right, so you're pulling back. I'm gonna change the seat position here on this one. So there's a number of ways that you can put the seat. I actually like it to be really high so I can pull back here more. Obviously we're a little bit different heights, but he wants to be able to pull back and be able to squeeze in here a lot, all right? So this is the exercise number one, and we're going for a 10-12 range here, and we're gonna pop right over here, and I'm actually gonna have him hold it inside also in here, because we're gonna get a little bit different stretch like this. Nice and upright, pulling the elbows straight down, squeezing the lats, all the way up to full stretch again. Now on this one, this scapular mobility is extremely important, because he wants the scapula to come all the way up, then he's pulling his scapula back and letting his arms follow through. That's how you really activate the lats completely. So it's not just a pull with the arms. You can't see, obviously, you'll be able to see on him. Scapula has to move all the way up and then they come back first. The arms follow through and it's all done rhythmically. So we'll start here. Good. Good. We're squeezing in here hard. There you go. Good. 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 Couple more. Good. Awesome. And then from there, he's gonna come right over here. Now this is a weight that he'll be able to handle fine. That's okay. We want him to really concentrate on getting the squeezes the right way. Good. And let's try to bring the elbows forward a little bit more. Yep, there you go. There you go. Scapula come back, and then we're pulling down. We're trying to really activate everything in here as much as possible. Good. Now as you show from the back, you can see everything's really, really firing. Good. Good. Go back again. Good. Good. There's a couple more, and then we're going to make this next one a little bit. Perfect. Good. 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 Keep going. Awesome. Keep going. Keep firing your heart. There you go. Come on. Come on. Two more. Keep going. Good. Good. Squeeze. Good. Walking right over here. Remember the scapula. Hit that full extension. Squeeze them back first. And the arm just follow through. There you go. Good. All the way back up. Let it open again. Squeeze back. Boom. Very, very important, guys. This will actually help you out on your shoulder days as well. Keep those scapula moving the right way. That's how you're going to really activate everything the right way. Good. Come on. Keep going. Bring it back. Squeeze. Let's do a couple more. Come on. All the way up. Squeeze. Give me another one. Come on. There you go. There you go. Very good. Awesome. All right. Can do it again. Come on. Good. 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 Yeah. Come on. Keep going. Good. There you go. Squeeze. Good. Over here. Get that full extension. Scapula back. Squeeze. Good. There you go. Perfect. Good. Come on. There you go. All the way up. Come on, two more like that. Come on, squeeze back. Another one. Come on. Full. There you go. Good. Rest, and we're gonna go through this one more.
Any good veins?
Couple.
Hey, couple. Sometimes they pop out.
All right, last one of these. Good. 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 Come on. Squeeze. Come on. There you go. Right over here. Keep going. Keep going for me. Another one. Squeeze, squeeze, squeeze. Keep forcing them out. Come on. Forearms are beat up.
Yeah.
So I'm gonna let them have a little bit of a break now. So we're gonna do a giant set now, and we're gonna really focus on him getting a lot of blood. We're going to focus really on the stretch and getting blooded. So I'm going to show you guys. So we're going to do three exercises. I just want to make sure I have this in the right spot first. Okay. All about stretch and feeling the lats in this one. So we're going to start out with a completely bent over rope pull down. So he's coming all the way up over his head and he's squeezing with his lower lats all the way down to his shins. Then coming back up again, you'll feel this all the way down in the insertion. Very important. This is essentially a dumbbell pullover, but you're doing it with this rope and you're doing it in the opposite direction, much safer on the shoulder joint. I can feel this all the way down into my waist. So we're nice and strict here, keeping the elbows in, driving with the lats to pull down. Now, from there, he's gonna come in. This is all about the contraction. So he's gonna lean back in here. I'm gonna take this band and he's pulling his elbows back and he's squeezing his lats as hard as he can. And what we're gonna do is we're focusing on the contraction, getting a peak contraction here, really, really pulling his elbows back, coming to extension, back again. We're gonna get 15 good squeezes like that. Then he's gonna finish off. He's gonna stay completely upright now. And he's doing a stiff arm pull down, really, really squeezing the lats down. And what I would tell people to do is when you do this, feel like how you are in your front relaxed pose. When you're really, really tensed out, that's where you want everything. This is gonna really, really pump blood into his lats now. We're focusing on that width today. So these stretching exercises and these contractions where you're gonna really feel it in the insertion, this is what's gonna help bring that width out. So this is gonna be too light for you, I know. So we'll change that a little bit. This one, by the time you're at the end, you're gonna put a little bit more than this, but you're not gonna wanna go too heavy because this one's all about squeezing everything down the right way. So for here, I think this will be good to start. So, you bend all the way over for these. Good. Keep your back arched up. Yep. Feel the stretch through here as much as you can. And then concentrate right here, squeezing down. Good. Now when you do these, you're gonna wanna keep your elbows in as much as you can. And really, really feel the stretch through here. That's what's gonna do it. So you think almost like driving down with your elbows. There you go.
Yeah.
And you're gonna wanna really concentrate through here as much as you can, feeling that stretch. Good. And getting that proper contraction through here. You're squeezing. Now when you tense everything the right way, you'll feel the stretch through here in the top. And you can pull down, and then you wanna really, really feel the tense through here. So we're gonna go for 15 reps, nice and strict like that. Good. 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 There you go. Good. Keep that back arched up though. There you go. Now concentrate here. Good. Good. There you go. Good. Now we're gonna come in. Kind of like when you're backstage and you're just trying to pump up. We're gonna pull back and squeeze real, real hard. There you go. Good. Try to pull everything back real hard. Come on. Good. 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 Come on. Good. Keep it going. Good. Good. Two more. Two more. Come on. Good. Nice. Real strict. Completely upright. Squeezing down. Stand up nice and tall. We're squeezing down here. Good. Pull all the way through it. Good. There you go. That vein's coming out all through here now. Squeeze. Come on. Try to squeeze a few more out. Good. Another one. Pull all the way through. Try to pull it right through your whole body. There you go. Give me another one like that. One more. Squeeze it all the way through. Good. Need to lighten this a little more just so you can get more of the squeeze out of it.
Holy shit.
Rest.
Very good.
Got some blood in there?
Looks like it.
On the squeezes here with the purple cable, I'll do a video on my phone in the back. You got all veins coming out through your ass now. It's nasty.
Hardly any food.
It's crazy. Like over there, you didn't have to sell the striations and shit.
Yeah.
But now, after these, when you came through here, the veins are like spider webs coming out through your lower back now. It's cool. These stretching exercises like this for your scapula are amazing for your lats. And a lot of people don't take the time to do this. I wish I did more stuff like this when I was younger, because that mobility in your scapula, it really protects your shoulders. We do so much where we're locked in place all the time, and what happens is you start losing the proper mobility in your shoulders. And so many bodybuilders focus on being locked in with their scapula at all times. This is what we're trained to do. But unfortunately, for what we're trying to do in bodybuilding, it makes sense. But as far as
health-wise and
functionality,
yes,
you're unfortunately not doing anything for mobility. Right. And what happens is you start doing regular things in life, like throwing a football or going to pick something up, and you freaking tear your muscles.
I don't even want to throw anything.
And that's why I think that I didn't do this when I was younger. I wish I did. If bodybuilders could take more time to get into some of the mobility exercises and functionality exercises, you'd probably have these hybrid guys that look not like Jay Cutler, maybe, but try to look like Jay Cutler, but can move around like an athlete. So that's if you start incorporating more of that stuff when you're younger, you can still build all the freaky muscle, but you'll be able to move the right way, and your regular activities won't hurt you as much.
Right.
I can't tell you how many guys that are like, I'm one of them, that are like, oh, I tore my bicep picking up my gym bag, or I blew out my shoulder playing basketball, or stuff like that, because your body just like starts losing its you know, functionality.
Yeah.
So we're trying to get a little bit of mobility in here as well, taking his muscles through as far a range of motion as possible. But then when I'm pulling him in here, it's because now I want him to get locked in and just squeeze again. So we're opening everything up, squeezing it back in, and then we're just forcing some more blood in here at the end. Now, this is something you could do in the very beginning of your workout, and then it would make everything else harder. Or you put it in at the end, and it's more of like an isolation type thing to just finish it off. We are gonna do one more thing after this, but we're gonna do after this in the easiest. Let's go through this again. Getting all the way over. Remember, keep those elbows in, so you feel that stretch through here the right way. Good. Come on. Good. Good. There you go. Come on. Good. There you go. Good.
Yeah. Oh, God.
Now, if you squeeze it real hard, it'll be up here. There you go. Squeeze.
Yeah.
Come on. Squeeze. There you go. There you go. Good. There you go. Then here, remember, very, very upright, and you're just squeezing through your lats. So stand very upright on these. You just concentrate on contracting your lats down as much as possible. And I always tell people, try to pull it like you're pulling it right through your body. That's how you really get that big activation of the body. There you go. Squeeze. 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 Come on. There you go. Keep going. Squeeze. Good. Get those striations coming out. Squeeze. Good. I'm gonna go through this one more time. How you feeling?
Good. Pumped. Really pumped.
What's your front last breath?
So I can do that right now.
Awesome.
Nearly flexing.
So is your back double?
Good. Nice. Barely flex it.
Yeah. Last time through these.
And I sell the 95.
Good.
Good.
Come on. Squeeze. Activate right here, real hard. Come on. Pull through it. Good. 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 Come on.
Oh, fuck.
I'm going to show you a variation on this. So what you can do is you're going to sit into it a little bit more like this. Mm-hmm. And you're going to pull your elbows down really hard towards your knees.
Oh,
and then come back up like this. So you're pulling them down. It's just like the old school Dorian Yates pullover.
Yes.
When you're driving with your elbows. So think about that. You're driving through your elbows like this. And you're going to feel it in your lower lats a lot. You can do a lot with these bands, guys. You just got to learn muscle function, what they're doing. So keep your elbows in as much as you can like this. You know, drive through your elbows down towards your knees in that arcing motion. Pull with your lats hard.
Good.
Now what can happen, guys, is as you start to fail like this, you can then go more upright, go back into a traditional row type exercise, and now just start squeezing back through here.
Good.
Stick your chest up a little higher when you do it. Now squeeze back. Boom, there you go. Good. Now this is going to change the stress a little bit. I'm going to bring it a little higher now. We're just prolonging the set and the intensity. Come on.
Good.
And then when he fails here, he's going back into these upright pulls. This is just to keep squeezing blood in here, guys. Now you're going into these strict. Stand up nice and tall. Good. Good. Get that thickness in here through the lat. Squeeze. There you go. Again. There you go. Good. 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 Squeeze. There you go. Good. Squeeze. There you go. Good. 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 I'm gonna let him catch his breath. And then we're gonna blow through this, okay? So here's what he's gonna do. He's gonna brace himself, the side that you're not using. You brace yourself either on your hip or your other leg, right? Full extension, squeeze. We're getting these rows going in, right? So we're going for 15 to 20 reps. And you're gonna switch arms. Same thing on the other side. You only rest is when the other side is going, all right? So as soon as that side's done, boom, switches back over. We're gonna go through that four times, and then his back workout is done. So make sure you're ready for these, because we wanna get a really, really good squeeze in it. He's done a lot already.
So four each side.
Yep.
Oh, fuck, BJ.
Here we go. Squeeze. Good. 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 Come on. Good. 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 Come on. Good. Keep going. Good. Good. Awesome. Good. Good. So you gotta do 17 on that side now. That was 17. You gotta match it. Good. 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 Come on. Good. Good. Come on, keep squeezing those lats. There you go. Good. 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 Almost done. Good. Nice. There. Come on. Let's go right through them. Good. 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 Come on. Squeeze. Squeeze. Squeeze, there you go. Good. Come on. Keep going. Keep going. Couple more. Other one. There you go. It's 15. You gotta do 15 on this side. Come on. Good. Come on. Good. Good. Keep that blood in. Come on. Good. Good. Come on. Good. Almost done. Last one. There you go. Now you gotta watch front. Come on. Woo! Come on, you gotta get 15. Let's go. 2, 3, 4, 5. Keep squeezing. Squeeze. 8. Come on. 9, 10. Keep squeezing them. 11, 12. Let's go. 13, 14, 15. Come on, man. You're almost done. Good. Come on. Squeeze. Squeeze it. Squeeze hard. There you go. Come on. Keep going. Come on. Got to match it on this side. Come on. You got a couple more. Last one. There you go. Last time through. Come on. Come on, man. Good. Come on. Squeeze. Come on. Keep going, man. Last side of the day. Keep pulling. Keep pulling. Keep pulling. Keep pulling. Come on. Give me four more. 3, 2, 1 more. Match it on this side now. Come on. That's 14. Let's go. That's 1, 2, 3. I'm gonna work out those imbalances like this. Come on. Come on. Good. Squeeze. Squeeze. 10. Come on. 11. 12, you got a couple more. There you go. Pull. That's it.
Shit. That was good.
For the whole lot.
Front lat spread, if you can hit it still at this point. Turn to the back. Woo. Got some blood in there. Back lat spread.
That's as far as back as I can go.
Open it all the way. Damn, we got some blood in there now, ladies and gentlemen. Awesome.
Woo! Nasty. Now let's turn to the back. Let's go back over by. Can you see a back lat spread? Awesome. Very good. I just wanted a couple extra just for the stories.
For sure, bro.
Very good.
Oh, shit.
Got a lot of blood in there. For how low of calories that you're eating, I'm looking pretty nasty. You have a very, you know who you remind me of? A lot. Physique has changed a little bit now that he's older, but I remember when we competed together, years ago. You remind me of Seth Ferocio.
Dude, I knew that was coming.
A lot.
I hear that all the time.
Similar build. I'll tell you what, I mean that as a compliment, because the year that he won his pro card,
yeah.
I was actually sitting backstage with him, and I remember he was leaning over on this bench like this, and he was just leaning there, and his glutes were nuts, but his back had the striations and the lats like yours yeah. do. And that when you were bent over, is what really reminded me of him. You guys have similar structures. In
Miami?
Yeah.
Yeah, I remember that year.
9 or 10.
I remember getting the magazine in the mail.
The funniest thing is that year, so we were sitting, this is a funny story. I've told this story on the podcast. So we're both sitting there. Me and him, we're you know, we knew each other, you know, nice guys, kind of bullshitting backstage. And we see this enormous guy walk by. It was Robert Bernica, right? Mm-hmm. Lithuanian freak. He had like 24-inch arms. And we're both like, holy shit. And I'm like, have you ever talked to him before? And he's like, no. And I'm like, he looks mean. And, you know, big bald head. He looked like just a murderer. And so I was like, I'm gonna go and say what's up to him. Which a lot of bodybuilders don't even want to talk backstage. So I went over to him and I was like, hey man, you look good. And he turned to me and he had a Ziploc bag filled with chocolate. And he goes, would you like some chocolate? And I was like, no thanks, but that's really, really nice of you. And he was like, you sure? And I was like, yeah. And then I walked away and Seth was actually eating, like, I think he was eating gummy bears.
Yeah.
And he was like, huh, chocolates. Maybe he's onto something.
Maybe he's onto something, yeah.
And I always like tell that story. And actually, Robert Bernica is a really nice guy. And I wound up like becoming friends with him after that. But the giant Lithuanian scary murderer was offering chocolates to everybody backstage.
Did he turn pro?
He did turn pro, not at that show. I don't think at that show. Actually, no, Cedric McMillan won the overall at that show. He did it shortly after that, I think maybe at North Americans.
Yeah.
And then he actually went and became a famous rapper in Poland.
What?
And I believe he also did some MMA fighting.
Wow.
Yeah, I'll show you him when we're on our way home, which we should leave now. Yeah. So there he is, guys. We had 3 hard-ass workouts with Stephen Wain. You like Florida, don't you?
Love it. Love it.
He already wants to move here.
Yeah.
It's what happens. But I was really excited to have him here. He's a very, very, very nice guy. Very humble. He's a freak show. But don't be afraid to go talk to those scary, freaky guys in the gym. They're often the nicest guys.
Yeah, I love to help.
So, and girlfriend's running around here somewhere. Oh, there she is over there, strutting it up on the treadmill. She likes it down here, too.
She loves it.
It's a fun place. You never know. It might move the whole family down here, guys.
Tell PJ we want to live here.
We'll see. We got a couple people down here. You never know. Thank you very much, Pure Life. Awesome job. Very, very good. It was a good week training with you. And that's it. Peace out, bye.